Fish Passage is a program in the Fish and Wildlife Service, and it's a great program. We have removed about 950 barriers nationwide, and we have also generated about $8 million of economic activity. So certainly it's a very important part of our program.
Aquatic organism passage, ecohydrology are fundamentally important to the country at large and for any kind of agency like mine that delivers infrastructure. We of course are primarily interested in, when we deliver infrastructure, in safe and reliable transportation. That we do that for a number of reasons that have to do with economic productivity and quality of life for people who live in America, and for environmental stewardship. There are other things, but the key, one of the key things we try to do when we deliver any project is to ensure that we're not harming the environment, that we leave the world in a better place than when we came in.
Well, from the standpoint of the fish, it allows populations to get back to their natural state in terms of the size of populations. Oftentimes, especially resident fish, if they're limited by fish passage, all of a sudden you go from having one big population to two smaller populations. From a genetic standpoint, you incur all sorts of costs, the potential costs and threats, added threats to the populations by having smaller population sizes. We're really looking at gene flow and whether or not they're able to move at the right time of year to spawn and get to that spawning habitat, or to move downstream and distribute throughout the system. So by using genetic methods, we can look at, and genetic methods and genetic techniques, we can look at whether or not gene flow is actually occurring between populations. And through fish passage, we can help to understand and prioritize perhaps which barriers are actually having a genetic impact on passage.
I think we've seen a movement not only towards a more sustainable ecosystem, a better diversity in our systems, protecting species that are threatened right now. So I think we're going to see more and more projects and needs for this kind of protection in the future. But because we're also living in a country with an aging infrastructure issue, and dams are right on the top of that list of aging infrastructure, there's going to be a need for removal of dams, especially associated with dam safety issues.
We're really excited about this program because we think we can have a real impact on the future of fish passage in this country. As we know, during the last 100 years, we've lost a great deal of the population of native fish, and this is a program that will be designed to help restore fish to their natural place in the environment.
I was involved initially in the curriculum guidance that was one of the things that helped lead to developing these kind of programs, these fish passage, fisheries engineering type programs. And so to me, this combination with U.S. Fish and Wildlife and UMass really promoting an actual program where we can get a master's in fisheries or ecohydrology, I guess they're calling it, is going to make a really big difference for us, because people like me, consulting engineer, need to hire people. We're looking for people with this kind of experience, and we've been having a really hard time.
We've just started this program just a year ago, and at this conference we've had an enormous number of inquiries about when we'll be producing new graduates. There are people interested in hiring students, young people who have this training, positions in the government, in consulting, all across the country, indeed all around the world.
Fish patches is not just about fish. It's about quality of life. It's about recreational opportunities. It's about water quality. It's about the future generations of Americans having an opportunity to see the native species that used to be in these reaches that have been blocked, now reoccurring, and we are recovering all of those aspects of the natural world. And so on top of that, you have an economic incentive to do that. A lot of people come to recreate, therefore generating economy within those local communities.